So now let's talk about functions and arrays. There are a lot of functions that deal with arrays, and part of this is because PHP started out so long ago and was not an object-oriented language, and so it has to do a lot of things that are not sort of natural in the language, and object-oriented patterns are more natural, as we'll see. Object orientation's coming to PHP. I mean, it's here, but things like arrays still kind of throw back to the pre-object oriented. So you'll see a lot of array functions that have array underscore in front of them, and that's a way of namespacing them to keep them out of colliding with other things. Some of them don't have counts. Some of them don't have, like count doesn't have array underscore in front of it, and it's for used for various things. So here is a series of array functions that we'll talk about. There's far more array functions that do things like merging and searching and flipping and doing whatever. Here's some that I tend to use a lot. So the first thing that we often need to do is check to see if a key is present in an array. And there's a couple of different ways that you can do that. So I'm going to make a little simple array, just append name and course and have a map. Array key exists is asking whether the key exists or not. And so that's asking the question, is this key in this array? And that returns us a true or a false. And in this case, it says it does exist. Now there's another way to do this called isSet. And isSet is a little stronger than just whether the key exists or not. If the key exists, isSet is true. And if the value under that key is not null, then this is true. And so we often use this in the form, or you'll see this all over the place, is a ternary operator. So this is a true or a false. Isset name, that's going to be true, and then this is the true piece of the ternary operator, and this is the false piece of the ternary operator. So what this basically does is this echoes this string right here, which is right there. On the other hand, this adder is not in the array, so it's not in the array, and so it's going to turn this to false, which means the false part of this is what's going to echo out, and so that happens. And so this isSet is a common idiom that you just have to get ready for, have to get used to. The isSet ternary operator combination is used heavily throughout PHP. In the future, and the future is sort of the present, in the future there will be a more elegant way to do this. And so what I mean by future, so PHP 7 has a new operator that makes this syntax a lot more elegant. It's called the Null Coalescing operator, and it is the double question mark operator. And the PHP documentation does the best job of explaining this, and it really basically does the exact same thing as that little ternary operator does, except with a lot more succinct syntax. So Null Coalescing operator is, it's either checking is the key present and is the value not null. So it's really checking two things. And it just is really a way to, as they say, even in here, it's syntactic sugar to make it look better. And I'll tell you what, I really like it. Now the problem is can you use it? And so PHP 7.0 has been around for a while, and I've got most of my servers upgraded to PHP 7.0. But because I write code for other people, when I'm writing code for myself, I can use PHP 7.0 because my server's 7.0. But I have not yet indulged in writing this code because I still want my code to run on various PHP 5s, and maybe who knows when someone can tell me when the safe time is to assume that everybody's to PHP 7, which is a good thing, and we all should get to PHP 7, but it's not there. And so this is the more elegant way to do this, if you can assume PHP 7, and you won't see, other than this, you won't see in the rest of this course any PHP 7 syntax. And so here we go. We make an array, we put two things in, and we're going to do an assignment statement. We're going to use the double question mark operator, which is really kind of like it's homage to the old ternary operator. And so what we're doing is we're assigning, if this exists and is not null, this is assigned into name. And if it's not, either null or doesn't exist, then that's assigned. So it's kind of like a Python get operation. And so name comes out to be Chuck. So I echo name equals Chuck, and so that's true. And that this the not found, because adder is not present in my array, adder is then not found. And so this is a way more elegant than this same thing. It is, these two things are the same, But prior to PHP 7.0, and if you are writing code that might have to run on pre-PHP 7.0s, you're going to need to do that. You're not going to need to write this older code. And that's there's no more succinct way to do that. We saw how you can use array key exists, but that's kind of long as well. This is pretty. I mean, this is one of my favorite things about PHP 7.0. And unfortunately, I can't use it yet. So, but that's okay. Okay. So there's a couple other things we can do. We've got the count, which just tells you how many items are in the array. Because so many things in PHP, a variable can have many different types. There's a series of functions that ask what type it is. So the isArray function gives you a true false if that variable, $ZA, is an array. And in this case, the answer is yes, it is. It's an array. And away we go. Okay, so there, because the PHP arrays maintain order, there is ability to sort them. The strange thing is the worst sort that PHP has is the one named sort. Because what sort by itself, and it actually changes the array, and so sort by itself changes the array in place. So if the array before the sort had this in it, it's going to sort it by the values, not the keys. Sort it by the values, not the keys. And it's going to produce an array that is integer-based. And so it actually wipes out the keys, but the values are now sorted. And they're given 0, 1, 2, 3. If you wanted to write a counted for loop to go through them afterwards, then this is a cool way to do it, because the counted for loop wants an array that's integer indexed and dense, compact, with no gaps. But I almost never, ever do that, because if I made a key value array, now if I made an integer key array, then sort's just fine, but if I'm making key value arrays, so I don't use it. But there are thankfully other ones. And for those of you who are coming from Python, boy, it's a lot. It's nice to have these sort functions that just do what you want to do. Okay, and so here we have that same array. That same array. We print it out. Comes out, right? Then we can do a case sort that says sort by keys. And then we print that out. Oh, isn't it pretty? Sorting by keys. Pretty, pretty, pretty. And then we have a sort. I don't know why they call it a sort. I would call it v sort. To sort by values. Then we print that out, and now it's sorted by values. This is like, why are you making me in other languages do this stuff? They're associative arrays. I want to be able to sort it by values, and I want to be sorted by keys. Just let me do it. And because it stays in order, once you've sorted it, it stays in order, so life is simple, and you can sort them however you want. So that's cool as heck. A lot of what we do in these languages is processing strings and splitting strings based on spaces or other characters. The historical accident that led to this being called explode. It might be because Perl called it explode. I don't know. I can never remember Perl because I don't want to remember Perl. But the function is explode. And because PHP is not object-oriented, you got to pass both the string and the delimiter in. And this is the delimiter, so break this on spaces, and that's the string, so just chop, 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 chop. Just breaks it into pieces and then sends us back, as the return value, it sends us back an array with the pieces. So if you want the 0, 1, 2, third word, there you go. It's, you know, $temp sub 3. So that's the third word. So another place that we see arrays in PHP is in the parsing of URL parameters when we hit in the request response cycle. So just a little example of this. Here we go with URL. So this is a big long URL. It's just a normal thing. It's part of HTML. But you can also put parameters. You put the question mark at the end of the URL, and then you have key value pairs, x equals 2. And if you have more than one, you put an ampersand and a second key value pair. What happens is PHP puts this into an array, a super global array called $get. And a lot of times we do use these, PHP uses these big global arrays, it's all uppercase, trying to tell you that $get is a special thing, it names it with an underscore. And so it just, you would have to write code to parse all this stuff, but it magically parses it and puts it in key value pairs in the array $get. And here we see it both with var dump and with $get. And I'm putting it in a pre-tag so it looks a little nicer, so the print art comes out nicer with the variable, so we can see everything. But that's, you can hit that URL, you play with it, and you can change these values, and you can see that these values change. And so it's a way of communicating from the end of the URL into PHP code. And the way you can kind of think about this is the request is going in and has x equals 2 on the end of it. And part of this thing where we always say parse the request, you know, it figures out which PHP code to run. And then it actually takes these x equals 2 and it places in $get. And that happens before the script starts. And so that is something that is defined at the beginning of the script when it all starts. Okay? So we've talked through a whole bunch of features of arrays. We've talked about the functions that you have to use for arrays, you know, how wonderful they are, the different kinds of sorting that you can do, and how the arrays work when they are part of a URL as well. So we'll find that arrays are just a really foundational data structure in PHP, and we'll keep learning more and more about how to use arrays.